Last month, for the first time in history, the Houses of Parliament were used as the set for a film.
Yes, Suffragette will tell the tale of the struggle for women to get the vote, a fight that saw tactics from peaceful demonstrations to, believe it or not, martial arts being used. Now, to tell us more, the original all-action glamour puss, Honour Blackman.
Karate chopping man throwing Kathy Gale in The Avengers broke down barriers of male physical supremacy over women on television. Never before had a woman been portrayed as someone who could hold her own in a fight against a man. My cape has caught the eye of the producers of Goldfinger, who then had the script rewritten to include martial arts, and I even wrote a book on self-defense.
Luckily, I've never had to defend myself in real life. Of course, I know I could if I have to. But for one group of women in history, it became an absolute necessity.
In the first decade of the 20th century, women were fighting for the right to vote. The suffragettes, as they became known, were growing in number. The movement decided they needed to defend themselves from the police, who they saw as an aggressive enemy. One woman was of particular importance in this change of tactics. Her name was Edith Garrud, a teacher of the Japanese martial art jujitsu.
In 1909, Edith taught here in Golden Square, London, with her husband William.
So how did Edith, only 4'11" in height, become such a key person in the fight for women's rights? Dr. Emmeline Godfrey is a historian who has researched the life of Edith Garrud.
In 1909, they were invited by Emmeline Pankhurst and the suffragettes to give a presentation. Everybody absolutely loved it. They said, well, can you become a bit more involved with us?
I don't think that I would ever have been able to battle through with a long dress or the black leather was more to the point.
Within 3 years, Edith was at the heart of the suffragettes' plans to resist police authority, including training an elite group of women to guard Emmeline Pankhurst. Edith and jujitsu became synonymous with the suffragette movement. One magazine even coined the phrase jujitsuffragettes, calling them a new terror for the London police. And on the 1st of March 1912, 150 suffragettes met for one of their most audacious protests yet. They were angry that shopkeepers, who were supposed to be loyal to them, weren't supporting the cause.
There'd be ladies walking across the street by the shops, innocently looking at the windows, and then suddenly they'd whip out items such as this hammer here. And this is a toffee hammer, which is small, and it can be...
It's quite weighty, isn't it?
And they would whip that out, smash a window, and run off.
The suffragettes escaped to Edith Garrud's dojo, where she provided them with a refuge.
They would put their items underneath the floorboards, they would get changed for a jiu-jitsu lesson, and then the policeman would come knocking on the door, and Edith would say, this is very, very unchivalrous of you to come in and interrupt a ladies' jiu-jitsu session. We're having a class. I don't know anything about it.
It was unusual for a woman like me in the 1960s to learn a martial art, but at the beginning of the last century, it was even more so. Sybil Evans and Jenny Cooper are Edith Garrud's granddaughters.
She could be quite domineering, but then...
When she was a suffragette, bossy bitch, was she?
Very bossy.
Yeah.
We knew she was a suffragette. We knew she threw people over her shoulder, policemen over her shoulder.
Yes.
But other than that, she was just Nana.
Did she ever practice anything on you?
She held my hand really tight and I had to pull her thumb back to get her hand off of me.
You didn't practice on your husband?
No.
So how difficult was it for a woman less than 5 feet in height, dressed in a full-length skirt and wearing a hat, to defend herself against a burly Edwardian policeman?
She was able to use the force of her opponent to throw him and demonstrate how a smaller person can beat a much larger person.
Can you imagine your grandma doing that? Edith Garrud was small in stature, but she was a big figure in the suffragette movement. And she proved that women could defend themselves just as well as any man.
Oh, she's feisty, isn't she, Mary? Now, this is what Mary looks like, without all of that period costume on. And now I'm about to experience what that policeman was going through. So here we go. With a punch, you ready?
Yep.
There he is, on the floor. Come on, Kylie, come on over. Can you take anybody down, Mary?
Yes. Within reason, yes.
Just hold him there for a little while. Yes. So how popular, then, is jiu-jitsu with women in the UK?
Oh, it's fantastically popular. So just how the suffragettes 100 years ago found that it's great for small women to empower themselves, it's still the same today.
Well, yeah, well,
I'm not quite as tall as Kylie, and I do okay. So.
Yeah, brilliant self-defence, then, isn't it?
Fantastic.
Right, we'd love to see...
Can I do it in high heels?
Yeah, absolutely.
Excellent. And we'd love to see it one more time. We didn't quite get it the first time. We'll just move back.
I'll show you something different.
Okay.
Different.
So this is a technique that Edith Garrud used in an interview when she was 94. So
what am I doing now? Punching again?
I'm going to punch. Yep.
Okay, ready?
Here we go.
Yeah.
And he's down. Excellent. Matt, up you get.
1 minute you look at, the next minute you're on the ground. Mary, thank you very much.
Very good. Well done. From us this evening. So huge thanks to Kylie.
Thank you. The new single
is out today. I was going to cancel.
Please, you didn't. Now, join us tomorrow when US talk show Titan Jay Leno is our guest. Good night.
See you then. Bye.
One step forward.